गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स, आई एम अनिल भगत, योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल हिसवा. वेलकम बैक टू आवर ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वील डिस्कस अबाउट वील रिवाइज अबाउट चैप्टर 10, दैट इज मोशन एंड मेजरमेंट ऑफ डिस्टेंसेज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, as the title suggests, we have to understand about the motion and measurement of distances. So what is motion? So motion is defined as if a body change its position with respect to time. If a body changes its position with respect to time, that body is said to be in motion. And if a body doesn't change its position with respect to time, that type of that state of body is called rest. So this is the rest and motion. Now suppose if a body moves from one place to another place, so how can we say that what is the how much space or how much distance it covered? So we need to measure that thing. So here comes the measurement, that to understand that okay, during motion how much distance a body covered, we have to measure that thing. So first of all, let's understand the previous or the ancient way of measurement of things. So first of all, in the ancient world, people move from one place to another place on their feet. They walk from one place to another place. Then gradually they are able to learn about the wheel, that how wheels help them to move from one place to another place. Then they are able to learn use of animals and wheels to carry things from one place to another place. After this, they are able to learn about steam engine, that how it will help them to carry them from one place to another. After a steam engine comes the normal motor engines. By the help of that, they move from one place to another. After that comes the aeroplanes, and nowadays we are traveling from one planet to other planet. The Mangalyaan is a very famous mission from our country, from our space research agency called ISRO. So now this is the condition of, or this is the developmental phase of motion of, or like traveling of peoples from one place to another place. So how we are able to measure these things? In the ancient days, people use different types of things for measurement. Like they use their hand span, they use their cubit, length elbow to middle finger. They used to measure like this one hand, or like one hand span. They use their difference between the one feet to other feet. So there are different ways by people used to measure things in ancient world. But these things are not going to give them uniform measurement. Suppose if a tall person use his hand to measure something, so that length, his hand is, the length of his hand is a little bit longer from a person of short height. So this is not going to give the proper measurement of things to us. So we need a uniform way to measure things. So peoples from all over the world sit together and they form a set of units by which we are able to measure things. And this set are called SI units, or International System of Units, under which we define the units of length, that is kilometer, unit of time, that is second, and unit of mass, that is kilogram. So meter, kilometer, gram, kilogram and second becomes the basic fundamental units, from which we can get some other units also. And to measure the small distances, we divide these units into small parts. And to measure long distances, we multiply these units and we get the bigger length, like 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter, 100 centimeter equal to 1 meter. So this way we are able to measure small and long distances. Same way, we must understand how to measure things in a proper way. So there are some steps we have to very careful at the time of measurement by the help of any instrument. First of all, we have to place the instrument properly. Then we have to mark them very accurately, and we have to maintain the eye position with the measurement tool with in a very proper way, or again we will get the bad measurement. So this is the story of measurement of distances in this chapter. Now comes the motion. So there are several types of motion in our day-to-day life. Like, first of all, there is a motion in straight line. There is a motion in straight line. So that type of motion is called rectilinear motion. There is a motion in a circular path, that is called circular motion. Under or close to rectilinear motion, that is when a body moves in a straight line, it is called rectilinear motion. But when a body moves in a curved line, it is called curvilinear motion. And when a body moves in a circular path, it is called circular motion. Under circular motion, there are two type motion. Always remember the motion of earth, that is earth move on its own axis, and earth also moves around the sun. So when earth moves on its own axis, that type of motion is called rotation motion. And when the earth moves around the sun, that type of motion is called revolution motion. So these are the two types of motion under circular motion. After that comes vibratory motion. Suppose if you hit the strings of a guitar, so it starts vibrating to and fro motion. So that type of motion is called vibratory motion, or you can say oscillatory motion. That is the motion of a swing. The next type of motion is called periodic motion. So periodic motion is the motion of an object, that is the object repeats its motion in a fixed interval of time. Means fixed interval of time it repeats its motion. The best example of this periodic motion is clocks, hands of clock. Okay, fixed interval of time they are moving again and again. So this is called periodic motion. There is non-periodic motion also, that is time is not fixed. Then comes the random motion. Objects move in a zigzag pattern, like motion of an mosquito, like movement of a mosquitoes. Mosquitoes move in a zigzag pattern. There is no proper pattern of movement of mosquito. So these are the main different types of motion we observe in our day-to-day life. So class, I hope you are able to understand the summarized discussion of topics from chapter 10, that is motion and measurement of distances. You can see the detailed discussion of these topics in the previous lectures, which is present in my YouTube channel. So you can search them and you can see those videos again and again. So class, have a great day. Be safe at home. Thank you.